Just it'll save a little time, so you can line up right now, concert choir people. Good. All right. Okay, I said concert choir, it should be chamber singers. Okay, let's get started. My name is Michael Sandvik. I direct the chamber singers, the concert choir, the wind symphony, and the string orchestra. And you'll also see Mrs. Green. She's our director for handbell choir. And I want to just welcome you to our Parent Day program. And all you parents want to say thank you for making your kids practice all those years. So really appreciate it. let's open our program with a word of prayer, and we'll worship together for a little while, and then we'll go home for Thanksgiving. Gracious Father in heaven, pray that you would be glorified, that you would be honored, that you would be present with us, that we would not leave this place further away from you, but rather closer to you than we came in. I pray that you would bless our mind, our hearts, in Jesus' name. Amen. All right, you're going to hear two pieces from the Wind Symphony. The first is titled Yonder Valley. It's the first of a set of Shaker songs that have been arranged for wind band by Frank Tichelli. And we'll go from there into the storm. And what I want to draw your attention to is this. Christ came into the storm of this world for us. It's a simple message, but a profound one. So here's Yonder Valley and Into the Storm. should acknowledge, you heard solos from Maren Molenbeek on the flute and Jeffrey Randall on the saxophone. Yeah. Thank you. Okay. The 6th century was perhaps one of the darkest times for Christianity. Infighting, struggles, compromise, persecution, slaughtering people in the name of Christ. It was a terrible, terrible century for Christianity. But there were beacons of light in that terrible time. Beacons of people that stood true for Jesus Christ. It's a reminder that no matter the challenge, if we stay faithful, Christ will live in us and through us. And we're reminded, how do we stay that way? We're reminded by keeping our eyes on Christ. And the first piece the chamber singers will share is a piece titled Tu Lumen. It comes from the 6th century, the text, not the music. And the text translates this way, talking about Jesus Christ. You are the light, the splendor of the Father. You are the enduring hope of all. Heed the prayers that your servants throughout the world pour out. I can only imagine in that time, in that century, when things were so terrible, that this prayer had extra special meaning to a lot of believers. When they say, heed the prayers, it wasn't just like a casual, like, oh, listen, answer our prayers, God. It was like, we need you desperately, because our lives might be over the next day because of our faith. Anyway, I hope you enjoy Tu Lumen. You'll hear two soloists. The soloist will be, who did I say was doing the solo? Okay. It's going to be Amelia Leek, and that's our Summer Jeech. And I hope you enjoy Tu Lumen. We'll follow that up with Wana Baraka. It's in Swahili, but we'll give you the words in English before we sing that one.
Thank you. Okay, the strings are coming up. I told you that chamber singers would give you the words in English, and I didn't have them do that because I flaked out. But what they sang about was, they have blessings, those who pray. Hallelujah. Jesus himself said so. They have peace, those who pray. Jesus himself said so. Hallelujah. They have joy, those who pray. Jesus himself said so. Hallelujah. They have well-being, those who pray. Jesus himself said so. I hope if your prayer life is needing a boost, this is the week to make it happen. There's no better time than now. So, great peace, great joy, great well-being. It's yours for the having. All right, the strings are going to, after they tune, will share two pieces. And the first is titled Polaris and Blue Mountain. And it's a reminder that God is our creator. Polaris, of course, refers to the polar star, the North Star. And Blue Mountain, if you've ever seen certain mountain ranges that are covered in, especially in evergreen trees, certain types of evergreen trees, when the light hits them, it's like, it's green, but it's got this bluish hue to it. Blue Mountain. And a reminder that God is our creator. concert choir. We're very blessed. We've got 81 singers this year, which is about 50% of the school. And huge blessing. Huge blessing. And we're going to share two pieces. The first being Sing to the Lord. And here's a setting of Psalm, and one of the Psalms. And what I want to especially bring your attention to is the part that sings, "Tell His salvation from day to day." And I just can't help but think, you know, it never gets old, the story of Jesus and His love, of His salvation for us. And I hope we never get tired of it, because we're going to be talking about it for eternity. I hope we are got a burning fire in our hearts to share that with others and those around us. People are especially open to the gospel, it seems like, around the holiday season, Thanksgiving and Christmas. Maybe think of that family member or friend that might just be able to have a word of encouragement. You don't want to be annoying about it, but a word of encouragement or pointing to Jesus. And maybe they'd be open to it this year. Pray for your people. Invite them into a relationship with Jesus. So, tell His salvation from day to day. And then we'll close with another psalm, "God is our refuge and strength." And I think it's pretty self-explanatory, but I think we need it. We need to be reminded of that. It's hard to tell His salvation from day to day if we're feeling disconnected. Maybe from God. So I invite you this right now to make God your refuge and strength as we hear these two pieces.
Bless His name, sing to the Lord a new song on the earth. Us in time of need, when the mountains shake, when the waters something. I did know it up there. It's easier when I'm singing it. but it says, fear not. So even when we are in the darkest times of our lives, I want you to think about how he reminds us. He says, I redeemed you. I've called you by name. You are mine. Whether you pass through the fire, you won't be burned. Through the water, you won't drown. He's always willing to be near to us and wants us to be near to him as well. And we can think about how we can actually find reasons to rejoice even in our time of trouble.
Close this program with a kind of sound gallery experience. And we've been blessed to have some very talented student composers. This is Johanse. He's been writing a fair amount of music. And you heard one of his arrangements yesterday at church with the string quintet. They premiered his piece, his arrangement of the Karis Chorus. And so he lives in two compositional worlds. He writes kind of more standard things like you heard yesterday, and he also writes a lot of electronic compositions that are in a cinematic style. This is the kind of music you might hear on a soundtrack or a movie trailer or a trailer for like a big public event, like an evangelistic series. Often they're done electronically. And that's where you actually create every sound all the way through. And sometimes those pieces can be transferred into live music, and sometimes they're meant to be just electronic. But he's been writing in this style for a few years now, and we're gonna premiere one of his pieces. And I told him, thanks for the burp cloth there, yeah. I told him he needed to have a title, he gave me a title just a few minutes ago, but this is The Last Sunset, and it's in a cinematic style. And just imagine you're like entering an art gallery, but for sound. So you're going to hear a recording, but it's all electronically created by Johanse. So I told him he didn't want to say anything, but I told him at least come up here so you can see who's been writing the music. And enjoy, and we'll have prayer right after this, and Mrs. Morgan will have some announcements, and we'll go home for Thanksgiving. So here is The Last Sunset by Johanse Mack.
Thank you, music department and Johanse. That was beautiful. Now, I know everyone is eager to get going, right? We're all ready to start our break. I just have a few quick announcements, and I'm going to rattle through these very quickly so we can keep our bus schedule on time. First of all, the buses are going to leave on time at 12:45, so students be ready. If you're on the Illinois bus, you're on number 17 in the Ad Building parking lot. If you're on the Ohio bus, it's number 14 in the church parking lot. So please be ready to leave in about 15 minutes. We're going to make this quick. If you are not taking a bus and you'd like to do some shopping while you're here in town, Rogers Natural Food and the Heartland Center are open today. If you'd like to stop in and get some vegetarian meat for your holiday. If you want to do more shopping, we've got merch out in the hallway. Mrs. Wallace will be out there if you want to buy some early holiday gifts. Also, while you're out there, pick up your kids' pictures. There's some handouts there, including the senior packets. If you haven't already taken those, please grab them. Student Association will be there with candygrams if they want to, if you would like to purchase some candygrams for the kids. What do you need? Okay, Mr. Sandvik would like the choir kids to leave their folders in the front. Okay. Seniors, please meet me in the business office for a quick minute before you leave. And I am going to rattle off the faculty families that have gifts for their children, so please find your family.